Radiohead get hacked for ransom, release all stolen material to donate to climate change protests.
Here's a summary of the article.
Experimental rock band Radiohead has released 18 hours of material that was stolen from lead singer Tom York's archived minidiscs by an unknown hacker. The hacker, or hackers, demanded $150,000 to keep it from being released to the public, Radiohead said. In response, the band decided not only to ignore the ransom demand but release the entire trove of music to Bandcamp in aid of Extinction Rebellion, the new climate change movement. A note on Bandcamp alongside the new release, seemingly penned by York himself, read, "We've been hacked. There's a lot of it. If you want it, you can buy the whole lot here. 18 minidiscs for £18. The proceeds will go to Extinction Rebellion. As it's out there, it may as well be out there. Until we all get bored and move on." The download, which comes in at a whopping 1.8 gigabytes in size, was posted alongside labels that had been on the covers of the compromised minidiscs. Speculation about the leaked material surfaced on the Radiohead Reddit page in recent days. "You can only use the tools at your disposal to get the messages across. You're left no choice. It's the same thing that's happening at the moment with Extinction Rebellion, who have run out of choices and are acting." In 2015, York told French magazine Telerama that fears about climate change had kept him awake at night.
This post received a score of 10,508, with an upvote ratio of 92%. Here are the top comments in response to this article.
"This is an amazing response from Radiohead. Turned a shitty situation into a charity opportunity. I love it."
Greater than in response, the band decided not only to ignore the ransom demand but release the entire trove of music to Bandcamp in aid of Extinction Rebellion, the new climate change movement. The most punk rock thing that could be done.
Hackers, give us $150,000 or we'll release all of the unreleased material we took, Radiohead, not if we release it first.
Didn't quite work like that. Someone stole it, traded it to someone for a rare track from another band. Then that second person tried to sell it for $150,000. He wasn't threatening to release it. The original trader then released it in retaliation, a week ago. So it was already out there. It's not like the band could control it. All that being said, this is the best response from the band. Hats off to them.
What rare track was it initially traded for? And where do these high-profile internet trades go down?
The internet, mostly.
Damn, I should check that place out. Don't bother, it's nothing but porn and cat videos.
I'm in.
Link for the lazy.
Shame to see none of their other music is available on Bandcamp.
Tom has released some of his solo material on Bandcamp before as an experiment. I think Tomorrow's Modern Boxes was originally released there.
Yeah, and through BitTorrent, lol.
I'm pretty sure Radiohead released their In Rainbows album with the price tag of whatever you wanna pay. This was the last band a hacker should have gone after. Completely predictable response.
I'm pretty sure. Fuck, I feel old.
Yeah, me too. That was such a big deal when it happened. Honestly, I think it was the only album I actually purchased in the last 15 years, and they offered it for free. Proves a point for sure.
How stupid do you have to be to think you could extort fucking Radiohead of all artists?
I'm no music person, but what's special about them in particular? Edit, wow, till. Thanks a lot for the info, peeps.
As mentioned by another comment, they released In Rainbows as Pay What You Want. And they have a reputation for thinking a bit differently than a lot of people in the music industry would.
Although they were never named by Radiohead, I always thought the Pay What You Want release was also a response to how angry and childish Metallica were over people stealing their music off Napster. Lars cried about it and Radiohead adapted in a super genius way. I do think all artists should get paid for their work, but when technology changes, everything changes. It went rogue for a minute, but now there's more ways than ever for artists to get paid for their music and, as a bonus, no one needs a big record label to back them and suck up all the money.
This video was automatically created by Reddit to Speech. The article and comments in this video were selected from Reddit according to their upvotes, and any paraphrasing was performed by smmry.com, without any human intervention.